Okay, so we are going to continue our sixth chapter of history. As we already discussed in our yesterday class also, that how Britishers build up many new forts and how Delhi become their new capital, because before the Delhi they are having their capital as Calcutta, na? So, and we also discuss about the various cities and we can say towns which were developed or built by the rulers of that particular time period, like Shahjahan built their Shahjahanabad in 1639. Okay, and like this we discussed that two things were included in the Delhi. Okay, and now today we will discuss regarding the planning of a new Delhi, that how Britishers plan for a new Delhi. Here one question is very important, that why Britishers are focusing only on Delhi? Prior they are having their capital Calcutta now, but they are focusing on the Delhi part. And have you learned about that? In just remember the point, in 1911 when the King George was crowned in England, for that also the Darbar was held in Delhi to celebrate the occasion. But the capital was the Calcutta, but still the Darbar was held in Delhi to celebrate the occasion. And in that particular Darbar only, the Britishers announced that from now onwards their capital will be Delhi instead of Calcutta. Okay, because you know the Mughals were focused on the Delhi portion only. Mughals were living in Delhi only. So that Delhi was belongs to Mughals, and Britishers want to finish the Mughal Empire and their kingdom completely. So that's why they believe that we should focus more on Delhi if we want to finish Mughal kings and their belongings completely. Okay, so in our today class we will study about all these things only, that how Britishers frame a new Delhi and how they are building new buildings and new places by comparing all those with the cities and buildings of the Mughals, because they want to show them superior as compared to the Mughals. Okay, so New Delhi was constructed as a 10 square mile city on Raisina Hill, south of existing city. जो existing city थी उसके south में जो Raisina Hills थे वहां पे उन्होंने क्या किया, New Delhi को construct करना start किया. You can underline this point. Okay, and for constructing New Delhi there were the two architects. One was Edward Lutyens and Herbert Baker. You are having these over here. Yes. And these were called on to design a new Delhi and its building. These two were the famous architects who designed new Delhi and its building. Okay. And after that, they built many more buildings also, or we can say palace. One is your Kingsway. Kingsway, you called it Rajpath. In nowadays, we called it Rajpath. And they also built a Viceroy Palace. And that Viceroy Palace, we called it Rashtrapati Bhavan. Okay. The Viceroy Palace, which they built, in today's scenario, it is known as your Rashtrapati Bhavan. Fine. Next building. And you know the importance of the Rashtrapati Bhavan. They copied that from the Buddhist stupa at Sachi and the red sandstone. They borrowed that design from the Mughal architecture. Means they are using or they can take a clue from the Mughal architectures only, but they are molding those ideas. Okay, and by molding those ideas, they are saying that we are designing our own Delhi or we are designing our own buildings. Fine. The next point, or we can say next importance, which is regarding this Viceroy place, is that the British want to architect made sure that the Viceroy Palace, which they are building, should be higher than Shahjahan Jama Masjid, because they want to show them superior as compared to the Mughals. That's why they made it very clear that Viceroy Palace should be higher than the Shahjahan Jama Masjid. Okay, now we will discuss that how was this to be done, that they are showing them superior, but ideas are from the Mughals only. Okay, so now New Delhi took nearly 20 years to build. Okay, they are having their own plans, they are having their own architectures with new plans that how they will build new buildings of New Delhi. And around 20 years after 20 years our New Delhi arranged properly. So here they are having new ideas. Now we will compare New Delhi with the old one. In the New Delhi, now there were to be broad and straight street lines. Okay, but earlier they are having very congested streets. Now the architects want New Delhi to represent a scene of law and order. They want that there should be proper law and order in the New Delhi, which they want to be followed. Okay, next point we are having that the new city also had to be a clean and healthy space, means from the point of the hygiene. They want new city a very clean and healthy place to live. And the next comparison with the New Delhi and the old Delhi is that New Delhi had to have a better water supply, as we already discussed in later, now that they don't have a proper water supply, they don't have proper drainage facility, the streets were very congested. Okay, so here we are having a proper comparison between New Delhi and Old Delhi, and in the New Delhi they are having proper and better water facilities, they are having proper sewage disposal and drainage facility also. Okay, now they are also focusing on more greenery, and for that they are establishing many parks for ensuring fresh air and adequate supply of oxygen. Okay, so this was the proper, you can say, the plan that how they are going to build a New Delhi. Okay, now we will discuss about the life in the time of partition. Okay, partition means partition was the partition of India and Pakistan. When India got freedom, then we have our partition. And at that time, thousands of people in Delhi were killed and their homes looted and burned. Okay, and what happened after that? This was a very, we can say, violence type of activities which were done at that time. Like many peoples were killed and their homes were looted and burned. And the Muslims left Delhi for Pakistan because they want to live in a Muslim-based country. So Muslims left Delhi for the Pakistan, and the place with their place were taken by equally by the large number of Sikh and Hindu refugees from the Pakistan. Means जब Muslims ने India को left कर दिया Pakistan के लिए, तो उसके बाद जो उनका place था, जो वो खाली करके गए थे वहां से, तो जो Sikh और Hindu थे जो Pakistan से आए थे, अब उन्होंने क्या किया, उनके उनका जो vacant place था उन्हें capture करना शुरू कर दिया, because they also want a place to live. Okay, and they forced Muslims to leave or sell their properties. And the Muslims who are not ready to leave the India, they forced them to leave their property or to sell their property. So like this, over 23rd of Delhi Muslims migrated. Migrated means moving or shifting from one place to another place. So like that, 2/3 of Delhi Muslims were migrated. And almost 44,000 homes were abandoned. Terrorist Muslims live in makeshift camps till they could leave for Pakistan. Means all those were forcing them to leave their homes and selling their properties. Na? So till that time that they could leave for the Pakistan, they live in the camps. Okay, but the scene is not ended here. Most of the migrants were from the Punjab also. When the partition occurs, na? So migrant are also from the Punjab. And when they don't have any place to live, so they stay in camps, school and gardens and anywhere where they found place to settle. At that time, new colonies are also build up, like you are having Lajpat Nagar, Tilak Nagar. ये जो आपके दिल्ली में जो famous जगह है, ये उस time पे ही आपके आई थी, क्योंकि उस time पे बहुत सारे migrants थे और उनके रहने के लिए कोई भी place नहीं था, तो ये जो cities थी ये उस time पे बनाई गई थी. Okay, and at that time schools and colleges were also opened because now population is more increased and now they want a proper education facility also for their kids. Now see what happened in the old city. This was we all are discussing regarding the new city, but what happened to the old city, old Delhi? Okay, now we will discuss regarding that. In the old city, there are some cities which were very congested, yes, and there are many cities which were not having proper drainage facility. So there were some changes in that also, that at the end of the 19th century, the Shahjahani drain, Shahjahabad city thi na aapki, so Shahjahani drains were closed and a new system of open surface drainage was introduced because they don't have any drainage facility. So what they did, Shahjahani drain jo tha usse band kar diya gaya and a new system of open surface drains were introduced. Okay, the Delhi municipal community was unwillingly to spend money on a good drainage system. They want to spend a good money on them, on that drainage system, but if the plan is passed, so they also have to spend on that particular system unwillingly because they don't want to spend money on that. Okay, so now we are having new concept regarding the Havelis. Havelis mean the decline of the Havelis because now they are building more cities and more towns on the basis of new architect. Okay. See, now the buildings which were constructed by the these Britishers, so the colonial bungalow were quite different from the Haveli. Havelis were represented by the Mughals, na? So now, and the bungalow represent the Britishers. But Britishers, every time they want to show them superior as compared to the Mughals. Okay, so now their bungalow are quite different from the Havelis. In the Havelis, we can say joint family is living in the Haveli. But when they build their bungalow, they want to build their bungalow for nuclear family. Okay, they want it for a small families. And how they build it? They built that was a large single story structure with a pitch roof and usually set in 1 or 2 acres of open ground. Are you able to see this picture? Yes, able to see this picture? Yes, like this, they are building their bungalows, which are quite different from the हवेलीज ऑफ मुगल्स. नाउ टाइम टू टाइम नो वन इज कंस्ट्रक्टिंग हवेलीज. नाउ एवरीवन इज फोकसिंग ऑन द बंगलोज ओनली. नाउ व्हाट आर द चेंजेस द म्युनिसिपैलिटी बिगिंस टू प्लान. व्हाट इज सेंसस. सेंसस होता है ना CENSUS. व्हाट इज सेंसस. कैलकुलेशन ऑफ योर पॉपुलेशन. And when the census held in every 10 years, हर 10 साल में होता है ना आपका जो census होता है. In every 10 years census, तो census होता है आपका जो population होती है उसकी calculation होती है. So अब देखिए how municipality they are role in census. The census of 1931 revealed that the world valid city area was horrible crowded. With as many as 90 persons per acre, while New Delhi had only about 3 persons per acre. Means जो census था 1931 का, उन्होंने इस चीज को रिवील किया कि जो ओल्ड दिल्ली है उसमें पर एकड़ में 90 persons रहते हैं, बट जो सॉरी ओल्ड दिल्ली में 90 persons रहते हैं पर एकड़ में, बट जो न्यू दिल्ली है उसमें पर एकड़ में सिर्फ कितने रहते हैं, ओनली 3 persons were living. And in 1888 एक एक्सटेंशन भी हुआ था. एन एक्सटेंशन स्कीम कॉल्ड द लाहौर गेट इम्प्रूवमेंट स्कीम वॉज प्लान बाय रॉबर्ट क्लार्क. अंडरलाइन दिस लाइन. इन 1888 यस स्कीम एक्सटेंशन स्कीम कॉल्ड द लाहौर गेट इम्प्रूवमेंट स्कीम. एंड द आइडिया वॉज टू डो रेजिडेंट्स अवे फ्रॉम द ओल्ड सिटी टू अ न्यू टाइप ऑफ मार्केट स्क्वेयर. फाइन, ऐसा नहीं है कि जो ओल्ड दिल्ली के जो लोग थे वो न्यू दिल्ली में अब आके रह सकते थे. नहीं, उन्हें उनसे क्या रखा जाता था, दूर रखा जाता था. एंड इवन इन 1912 वाटर सप्लाई एंड ड्रेनेज इन द फ्यू लोकेलिटी वर वेरी पुअर. दे वर फोकसिंग ऑन द ड्रेनेज सिस्टम बट स्टिल लोकेलिटीज वर वेरी पुअर ड्रेनेज फैसिलिटी. नाउ वी आर एट द एंड ऑफ द चैप्टर एंड नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट for the improvement and for the improvement in Delhi that the Delhi Improvement Trust was set up in 1936 and it built area like you are having Daryaganj south for wealthy Indians. Focus on the word Indians. Yes, so Daryaganj in south was built for wealthy Indians. Okay, houses were grouped around the parks. Now Indians are also building their houses similar to the bungalows of the Britishers. Okay, now different member of the same family had their own private spaces within the home. They are having their different, you can say, room. Okay, so this was the all about your today's class, that how old Delhi was converted into New Delhi and what were the plans for the New Delhi and which organization was set up to frame New Delhi and how they improve the drainage system and the, you can say, law, and they improve law and order in New Delhi. So I hope the chapter is clear to you. This was all about your today's class. Thank you all of you.